Hey, all y'all NF fans thought I forgot about y'all, huh? Forgot about this journey that we supposed to be on together. Everybody telling me to go back to his beginning album. See, not Carr, you getting it, but you not really getting it. You gotta go back to the beginning, the roots of NF. I told y'all, I said, bet, I'm gonna go back, listen to his beginning album. We're gonna start from there together. So this is my first time listening to NF's debut album that he dropped in 2015. Mansion. But before we begin, fam, don't forget to go on my reaction playlist and go check out some of the songs that I've did already from NF that brought me on this journey to begin with. So if you guys want to come on this journey with me, every Thursday will be guaranteed an album reaction will be dropping, but some weeks I'm actually going to pump out a lot more. Consider subscribing. It's your boy Jakar. Let's begin with track number one, intro.
A Michigan-born rapper with lightning quick delivery and a troubled past might call to mind a certain rap bet. But the Eminem comparisons end there. I like that they end there. NF's debut is a dark, ultimately hopeful account of the MC's personal struggles in Christian faith. He pulls double duty singing and rapping on Wait, a mournful piano-driven love song, and experiments with EDM-inspired beats on high drama accountability anthem Face It. The eerie, pounding title track takes a conceptual tour through the mansion of his mind, each room housing a life-altering trial he's striving to overcome. Each room housing a life-altering trial he's striving to overcome. Mansion. Wow.
I'm looking like I'm gonna get it, you probably don't get it. I come in your house with a microphone looking like I'm about to set up a show in your kitchen. I'm out of my mind, but I feel like I'm in it. If I never make it, don't make any difference. I'm stuck in the killer, you know what the deal is. I never know telling when I'm in the building. And if it's a monster, I am. Don't try to figure me out. I grab on that microphone, job and they cry. They was laughing at me. Who they laughing at now, huh? I laugh at myself. Some people, they looking like wow. The moment you told me that you was a rapper, I couldn't believe it. You believe it? And then Capital came in the picture and gave me a shot. And look at it now, I look at the team I'm dealing with. These people ain't playing around. Looking back, I got a lap. I was in a whole different place a year ago. I look at the map and thank you God, I swear it's a miracle. And I'm sorry, but I gotta leave. My man, this track was beautiful. The least I can do if I murder a beat is take the time to go to his funeral.
Well, shit, and if that's how you start an album off. Damn, I really like how he just gave us the entire journey. Like he said, people like, oh, you a rapper? Don't you see that I'm a rapper now? Like before you was questioning. A lot of people was questioning him. You could tell that was like his. He said, I'm not cocky, I'm confident. He said, I'm not cocky, I'm competitive. He has that burning hunger. I could see why a lot of people love him. Not only is it refreshing to have someone that's just spitting crazy and not saying nothing. Like he's saying a lot of substance, but he's rapping fast. And you could hear what he's saying while rapping fast. That's important, you know, that's really important. Track number two, featuring Flore. Hope I said her name right, or his name right. Mansion.
Insidious is blind inception. What's reality with all these questions? Feels like I missed my arm and slept in.
I reacted to this song before.
Slept in.
I love the airy BTS.
My mind is a house with walls, covered in lyrics. They're all over the place. The songs in the mirrors, written all over the floors, all over the chairs. And you get the uncut version of life when I go downstairs. That's where I write when I'm in a bad place and need to release. And let out the version of NF you don't want to see. I put holes in the walls with both of my fists till they bleed. You might get a glimpse of how I cope with all this anger in me. Physically abused, now that's a room that I don't want to be in. That picture ain't blurry at all, I just don't want to see it. And these walls ain't blank, I just think I don't want to see them. But why not? I'm in here, so I might as well read them. I gotta thank you for this anger that I carry around. Wish I could take a match and burn this old room to the ground. Matter of fact, I think I'm up on this room right now. Somehow this memory for some reason just won't go down. You put me in the corner so you can see the fear in my eyes. Then took me downstairs and beat me till I screamed and I cried. Congratulations.
I usually don't pause songs. I'm not gonna keep that going. You guys know how I rock, but I just wanted to add, and I didn't pick that up the first time I heard Manchin. I think this is the first song I ever heard from NF was Manchin on my channel. So look at what he said. He said, "I wish I could take a match and burn this whole room to the ground." I believe this room is like all the physical hurt, because he was talking about the fear. He's talking about being brought into the basement. He's talking about all the pain. Matter of fact, I think I'm gonna burn this room right now. Somehow this memory for some reason just won't burn down. That room is memories. You know, every single room that we're about to go through on this song is going to be a memory of his, and not even memory, just trauma, you know, or different experiences that are mashed up inside of that room. So this is the physical. I believe he started with that, right? He said physically abused. Now that's the room that I don't want to be in. So he's kind of walking by the room, but he's talking about it. That's the room I don't want to be in. I kind of want to burn this room down, but it just never wants to burn. Wow.
Yo, my mind is a house with walls covered in pain. See, my problem is I don't fix things, I just try to repay. Cover them up like it never happened. Say, I wish I could change. Are you confused? Come upstairs and I'll show you what I mean. This room's full of regrets, just keeps getting fuller, it seems. The moment I walk into it, it's the same moment that I wanna leave. I get sick to my stomach every time I look at these things. But it's hard to look past when this is the room where I sleep. I look around, one of the worst things on these walls was the moment I realized that I was losing my mind. One of the first things I wrote was, I wish I would've called. But I should just stop now, we ain't got enough room in this song. And I regret the fact that I struggle trying to find who I am. And I'll lie to myself and say I do the best that I can. Shrug it off like it ain't nothing, like it's out of my head. I get sick off whenever I see it affecting my plan.
And I regret watching these trust issues eat me alive. And at the rate I'm going, probably still be there when I die. Congratulations, you'll always have a room in my mind. The question is, will I ever clean the walls off inside?
On a lesser level, I definitely feel the same exact way he feels right there. And I think most of us do. He said a lot of things that we all feel. And I think that's why that's the room that he sleeps in. Meaning, if he sleeps in that room, that's his main bedroom. Like, that's his room. It's not the room that he's walking by. It's not the room that he got locked up. It's not the room that he's never going to go inside again. This is the room that he's in all the time. Every single night he's in this room. And like he said, he's repainting the walls instead of trying to heal and fix and go to therapy and do all that type of stuff, right? I'm not going to fix the issue. I'm just going to put a band-aid on it. And a lot of things he said I could relate to, and I know a lot of us can.
My mind is a home I'm trapped in, and it's only inside this mansion.
So this part of my house, no one's been in it for years. I built a safe room and I don't let no one in there. Cause if I do, there's a chance that they might disappear and not come back. And I admit, I am emotionally scared to let anyone inside. So I just leave my doors locked. You might get other doors to open up, but this door's not. Cause I don't want you to have the opportunity to hurt me. And I'll be the only person that I can blame when you deserve me. I'm barricaded inside, so stop watching. That's a problem, cause I've been dealing with this ever since. I thought that he would leave, but it's obvious he never did. He must have picked a room and got comfortable and settled in. Now I'm in a position, it's either sit here and let him win, or put him back outside where it came from, but I never can. Cause in order to do that, I'd have to open the doors. Is that me or the fear talking? I don't know anymore.
Is it me or the fear talking? I know that that is the title track. I know I reacted to it before, but you guys were right. I love it more now than I did before, just doing the song reaction. And I'll be honest, you guys, I think I just want to do album reactions. Maybe I'm going to do a few songs here and there, but I'm an album type lover. I like to really get the whole feel for things, especially if it's a concept album. And before I go dive into the song, I just want to add this before I forget about it. He reminds me a lot of like a hard rock rapper. What I mean by that is his passion, how loud he is, how aggressive he is, right? It's just a lot of that that I love when it comes to some of the hard rock where they're just really going after it. But he's rapping. And that's so dope. And I'm shocked that this is his debut album. Like, this was what he came out with, bro. Like, that's crazy to be so vulnerable like that. And also, I love the ending of the song. That's what really made it a 10 out of 10 for me. It would have been a 9 out of 10. But if he would have brought back the whole chorus again, I liked the switch up. I liked the it's lonely, it's lonely. And then the space after, is that the fear or me? And then, of course, at the end, having her come back for just to say it one last time inside this mansion. Perfect song. 10 out of 10 song. Let me know, you guys, is this his best song he's ever made? I'm going to listen to, of course, the rest of the album and more of his albums. But let me know in the comments. Track number 3, All I Have.
Long time, but I'm back now. Rap out, welcome to the rap house. Rap out, would it live till I pass out? Blackout, blackout. Everybody keep on wondering if I still rap now. Are you serious? Anybody out there hearing this? Yo, I came in the game as a lyricist and I'ma leave like that, period. You sniff lines, I write lines. You've now entered in my mind. And you better get ready cause you might find I'm from a different place in my kind. It's a little bit different than yours. Quit slumbering, hip-hop isn't dead. It's just been in morning. From the moment I quit recording. This. Don't tell me that this isn't real. Don't tell me this ain't how I feel. This is all I have, all I have.
I wonder if somebody to get this. All I ever wanted was somebody to play this. Yeah. Take my song, put it on their playlist. They get goosebumps every time they play it. Wait, this my calling or not, Father? Maybe I should just not bother. Go back to that 9 to 5, but I am not a quitter, so quit that. I never been a killer, but I guarantee I kill tracks. Put him in a coffin, lost it. Rip that, trying to make an impact in rap. Is that insane?
Well,
I guess so. Rapped all, but they give me that pencil. And you ain't never gonna make it. It's all mental. I am in a place where I can't let go. I still work a job and do this. And y'all know it's stupid. I thought all you had to do was get a record deal and your thing start moving. But that's not the case because most of the time the artist you hear, you keep on thinking that artist is new, but that artist has probably been at it for years. Yeah, in the back of my mind.
Yup.
Am I wasting my time dreaming? And I ain't gonna
say a lot.
I'm gonna guarantee the way that I ain't gonna leave this. I need this. I swear to y'all, I need this. And this hip hop's in my veins. If you cut me, I'ma bleed it. And yo, what you think I write rational reason? No. Take my pain and I put them in the song. Since them pills, they took my mom. I've been a different person. Don't try to predict my verses. What you're hearing now is me. Whether I'm in front or behind that curtain, I stand behind these words. I'm a Christian, but I'm not perfect. Don't tell me to calm down. I'm calm now. Listen, I'm just working. Yeah, it might take a minute to get it, but once you get it, everything will be crystal clear. I don't think they see my vision here. I don't think they see my vision here. Don't tell me that this isn't real. Don't tell me this ain't how I feel. This is all I have, all I have. Don't tell me that this isn't real. Don't tell me this ain't how I feel. Oh, this is all I have, all I have. Don't tell me that this.
Yo, what the fuck? I actually really love that song. What is going on? Yo, that's a 10 out of 10 song to me, bro. That at first, I can't lie. At first, the first verse, I didn't really know where he was going with it. He was talking about hip hop. He was talking about, you know, reviving and all that type of stuff. We hear a lot of rappers talk about that. So I'm like, all right, well, you know, we'll see what he's about to spit. But I loved the chorus at first. I said, hold on, this is all I have. Don't tell me that this isn't real. The second verse really got me. It really pulled me in. First off, his quickness rapping and speak crazy. And his passion, bro, It's like he's drinking an energy drink. It's like he's like so, but you can still know what he's saying. And that's the difference. You got a lot of fast rappers out there. You don't know what the fuck they're saying. It's like, get it together. Slow it down. But for him, I know exactly what he's saying. But also, the chorus again afterwards really got me. This dude know how to sing. He know how to make a song, bro. He know how to make a song. That was a good-ass song. That's something that I will listen to and be excited to hear it to the end. Like, the ending is going to be like, yo, I already know he about to come in and sing at the end. I already know he's going to bring that passion. And I want to pick apart his words more. I think that's the first song that I would actually, like, really save. I know we're only on track 3, so you know what I'm saying. But just saying. Track number 4, Wait. Song my bro told me to listen to.
Wait, don't leave me. Where you going? Where you going? Where you leaving? I can't lose you.
I can't believe this. Yo. This album's really fire. I can tell.
Don't you love me? Don't you love me? Yes, you don't want me. You don't want me. In the hotel room like why? Call your phone and apologize. Gotta be a way we can make this right. We can make this right.
Hold up, hold up, piece of us.
A desperate kind of love, but it feels like it's home. Wait, 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 don't leave me.
I wanted him to say it one more time.
Wait, don't leave me.
We are 4 for 4. Such a beautiful song. I wanted him to just end it with the Wait again, and he did it. He's right, you know. I can only imagine 2015 NF. He's really starting to take off. Of course, things would never be the same, like he said, with some of his friends, family, significant others, you know, people that he's met, whatever. I'm saving that one too. Wow. Track number 5, Wake Up.
You make a lot of money and you live in a mansion and pretty much got everything that you could ever imagine. But you feel like even though you got everything in the world, you got nothing. So what you do then is you start going backwards. Cause you live your life in a coma, you never awake.
Yo, a lot of people not awake. That's a fact. You're not awake. This might be good for when you're running or lifting. Might work.
In a dream that you can escape.
That's a nightmare. That's a nightmare. But...
Cause you live your life in a coma and never.
Wow, yup. Heal yourself, you gotta wake up. I think that's the song that is going to help a lot of people. Well, already helped a lot of people. That's the one that really helped people, I could tell. That song has a lot of potential for me. I feel like half of me is like, I really wouldn't like a song that's just saying, wake up like that. But the other half feels the impact and feels how good it is and how good it's doing that it's like, nah, bro, you got to love this song. Like, so, but all in all, it's straight though. Track number 6, Face It. Face it. I wonder what this will be, but it's kind of, it might be him facing his problems, facing the rooms in the mansion.
Lately. I ain't sleeping lately. Yes, I know that I'm the only person that can change me. Maybe that's why I ain't changing.
Yeah.
That's why I ain't changing. I got too much on my mind. I guess I don't know how to face it. I just don't know how to face it. I don't know how to face it.
Oh. EDM in the back.
Let's go back to basics. Yeah, say what you mean, do what you say. But man, I hate this, I just don't know what I'm chasing. I ain't saving ready.
You gotta know when it's the devil talking to you.
Yes, I know.
That ain't God, fam. That's the devil talking to you. Shit ain't great. Fix yourself, bro.
That's why I ain't changing.
Work on yourself. It's you. Only you could do it. He's right.
Face it. I just don't know how to face it.
None of us do. We don't know how to face this shit. Yeah.
I don't know how to face it.
This is probably real good at the concerts. In the last song too. That's a good ass song. That's a good song right there. We're at half the album, right? And if I'm not being too critical, I could say straight up, he's 6 for 6 right now. There's not one song so far that I've been like, nah, I don't want to hear that shit ever again, or like, that was a bad song. Whoa. NF, my brother, good shit. Track 7, Motivated. Yeah, this might be the one for me.
I've been doing this a long time. I mean, over half my life. It's awesome for me to be able to put out music that people will actually hear. Especially when you put this much time into something that you love, something you have a passion for. That's motivation.
When I first started, never knew if they will listen, but when I write, that's Mel Gibson. If music is a disease, I promise I'm infected. I dream on different levels of dreams. Inception, these beats are my playground.
That was tough, the Inception. Dreams into other dreams, Inception. The movie's about. I like that I'm motivated towards the end, but I feel like that's definitely the first song I'm gonna skip on, to be completely honest, though. It's just not for me. Track number 8, Notepad.
You and I, we've been doing a lot together. When I look back and I appreciate all the times that we had together, you know? I remember just going down in my room and, you know, trying to deal with some things. And you've always been there for that. Always. It's me and you.
You and I've been best friends ever since I was a young kid. Everything we did, where's time went? Got a lot of years coming up ahead of us, and ever since we met, I knew we'd get somewhere. But the fact is, I ain't really know when. I don't really know how either, but I can feel the goosebumps. My skin writing, I've been waiting for the moment. You and I can make it happen. A lot of people think we ain't gonna make it happen. I ain't got a problem with them, no, that don't even matter. We ain't looking for the people trying to say that we the baddest. No, I never liked that. Came a long way, never did it for the money. We ever make it big, I'ma give it to the family. Looking back now, everything is looking funny. You and I in the room writing. Up late when the mood strikes us. We don't care if they do like us. Backpack took you in the school, writing on you like it's nothing like a paper.
There you go.
See me scribble on the page, but they ain't got to
talk about him and his notepad. I know it's called Notepad. I don't know why I was so late for that.
Made it and we did it. You ain't nothing but a notepad. Tell me who you kidding. I'm just running out of space. I'll be back in a minute to the page, homie.
You know what's crazy is, this just started as something that was an escape for us, you know?
And it's just a way to vent, get everything out. A release, a healthy coping mechanism. And now he realized so many people going through the same thing. It's like, he changed their lives, he helping people. So dope. It's funny, it took me so long to even think about that. Like, I'm looking at Notepad, I'm like, who is he talking about, a childhood friend? But, that was a really good conceptual song right there. I can't remember. That was cool. That was cool. Track number 9, Turn the Music Up.
Red Bull in my hands, feels like I got wings. Lot of people in my face, but I can't hear a thing. It's like my head's up in the clouds.
I bet he had raves this year, just like concerts, and they going crazy with this song. Come on, though, so I'm not hating. All right, so before I get into how I feel about the song, this is a quick little breakdown that I thought of. Correct me if I'm wrong, NF lovers out there, but at first I was like, he didn't need this song on this album, right? And I still feel that way. I feel like he doesn't need this song on this album. The way that it's a concept album and everything, he doesn't need it. But I thought about this on the Defensive NF. We just listened to Motivated, which was kind of like him talking about how he's motivated to go hard and get after it. And then he's, now that he's motivated, he's thinking about his notepad, right? He's thinking about, how did I get here? I started off by just writing in my notepad and I can't believe I got here to this point. But now he's saying, I didn't think that Turn the Music Up was needed, but then he started saying, you must be out your mind. So he's kind of talking to himself still, looking at himself and looking at the different rooms in the mansion, kind of talking to himself saying, damn, you really must be out your mind. Like, the only way that you've been able to cope is with music. Like, what if you didn't have music? All right, you know what? The voices are getting loud. Everything's really getting insane. Let me just turn the music up. Meaning, let me go harder. Let me put out some more music. Let me lock myself in the studio. Let me stay away from everybody. Let me do what I gotta do. And it also can mean literally turn the music up. Like, just block out the noises from the sounds. So that is me being on the defense of NF for this song. But I'll be honest, even still, I don't believe you need this song on an album. But let's see if with the last three songs, he can end the album off right. In my opinion, this next one we're about to listen to got a star next to it, so it's one of the most popular ones on this album. Track number 10, Paralyzed.
When did I become so numb? When did I lose myself? All the words I leave my tongue.
Like, man, am I numb, or just certain things happen inside of my life where I'm like, yo, am I numb now just because of certain things, and just am I paralyzed? I like how he put it that way. Am I paralyzed? Because that's another form. Yeah, your emotional paralysis. Damn, beautiful song. Track number 11, I'll Keep On, featuring Jeremiah Carlson.
Oh, these hands are tired.
Oh, I like the switch up. We needed something like this.
Soul is tired, but I'll keep on.
Yes.
I'll keep on.
This is kind of like gospel. This is like gospel music.
Faith is something I'm not accustomed to. I'm trusting other people, something I don't really love to do. I've never been a fan of it. I act tough, but really my shoulders, they ain't built for this, and I don't have nothing. It's like I'm standing in the rain, and you offer me a raincoat, but I would rather stand than wring it wet than take the hand out. What's wrong with me? You said you've always got your hands out, and I cannot continue on my own, so take my hands now. I don't care if they remember me, my life will always have a hold if you are not the centerpiece. Take me out of bondage, take all of my pride. If I don't have a savior, I don't have nothing inside. Take all of my lust, take all of my lies. There's no better feeling than when I look in the sky in your eyes. It's amazing.
Oh, these hands are tired.
Take all that shit, man. Take it all. Take it all. I don't want it. All I want is God.
I'll keep on.
You're the best version of me. That's it.
I'll keep on.
That's all you need is God and trusting yourself, trusting the best version of you is about to come up. I usually don't like it when songs do that. That ooh, oh, well, forever at the the end of the song, so I wish he didn't add that in there, but and you know what, before I get my final thoughts, I want to listen to the last song, and then I have some thoughts that I gotta share. But I really love the guitar. Jeremiah Carlson did amazing. That was a great addition. And I knew right from his name, Jeremiah, I was like, hold on, this might be a Christian song. This might be some gospel. And definitely was. So it's definitely a really happy, a beautiful, almost ending to the album. Track number 12, Can You Hold Me? Featuring Britt Nicole. I like that piano. I'm just looking at trees swinging and the leaves falling, and it adds a better feel. I'm happy I'm listening to this album in fall, almost winter, instead of like summertime. That'd be a little, seems like.
It feels like a tear in my heart, like a part of me missing, and I just can't feel it. I've tried and
she can sing. Ooh.
And I've tried.
Tears on my face, I can't take it. If lonely's a taste, then it's all that I'm tasting. Do you hear my cry? I cry.
Hey, so that is NF's debut album, Mansion. I just want to give my final thoughts. I'm just, my mind's everywhere. We listened to a lot of different songs, a lot of deep stuff. You got to really think a lot and feel a lot when it came to this album, but hopefully I could organize them as I'm going through this last review. So for the first six songs, those songs are all 9 to 10 out of 10 songs, in my opinion. The intro took off beautifully, went into Mansion. We breaking down, we get to get inside the whole concept of the album, which is the mansion, but it's each room has its own experience, its own feelings inside of his life. All I Have and Wait really snuck up on me. I didn't know these songs before, right? These two might be my favorite songs in the album, All I Have and Wait, to be honest. What he's really good at is giving objects or giving spaces deeper meaning, right? The mansion isn't just a mansion, it's a double meaning, it's a triple, you know, meaning. There's rooms and there's experiences, all that stuff. So he's really good at that. So Notepad is also one of them. But Turn the Music Up, don't like it at all. Don't really see why we needed it. But then here's the thing. The last three songs are really, really tricky. Paralyzed is a beautiful song. It is. But I don't know if I'll ever really want to hear it again. I'll Keep On. The first half is beautiful. The guitar is beautiful. Jeremiah Carlson really, really does great. But I don't know if I ever want to hear the second half again. And Can You Hold Me, Britt Nicole did fucking, she killed it. But I don't know if that's what I would like for the last song on the album to be. This is my only issue with the album, because besides that, it's beautiful. This is just the beginning. I know that each album There's a story to it. So he couldn't just close it right here, which I do, which makes me understand and be okay with not feeling resolved. Because that's how I feel. I don't feel really resolved from the mansion at all right now. I don't really feel like we cured too much, because here's the thing. He was talking about his mansion all the way to Face It and then being motivated with the rap game, track 7, the notepad. It kind of seemed like he lost the topic. Right when we ended track 6, Face It, it seemed like he kind of lost his focus on the mansion. I still want to dive into the mansion. I hope that the next album, you know, we dive into, because it seems like we left the mansion after the song Mansion. And Face It, he said, I don't know how to face it. Then in Paralyzed, he's talking about, why do I feel this way? He's asking a whole lot of questions. But I feel like we needed a song in between Paralyzed and I'll Keep On. He's feeling down, but he's like, but I'll keep on. Why are you going to keep on? I kind of feel like we needed that God song. You know what I'm saying? The Christian God song. I could be tripping, but I feel like we needed that God song. If he could put Notepad, Paralyzed, and then a song of resolve, going back into the mansion, but kind of maybe he burns down the room this time or does something like that. Could be another album. It could be another album that these things happen, right? So I understand. I just wanted to get that off. And then the last song, Can You Hold Me? I don't know if that's the ending that I wanted, but that was the only thing that I really was thinking about. I was like, man, I wish we had another song that could go back into the mansion before we end the Mansion album. But that's my only issue. Besides that, the wordplay is amazing. His lyrics were amazing. His voice, the beat, the entire vibe, the feeling, everything was just, this dude's amazing. I really, really love NF. This made me more of a fan and more of a, I feel like I'm more open to his next albums now. I feel like I'm like, yo, I can see myself adding some of his songs to my playlist and being excited for if people are like, yo, you know, NF's about to drop a new album. And I'm like, oh shit, I gotta hurry up and listen to the rest of his album so I can catch up. It's like watching a, it's like, yo, you know, Spider-Man 4 about to drop. And it's like, oh shit, I gotta hurry up. I gotta catch up. I gotta catch up to the rest of them. Not me though. I'm already caught up. Die hard Marvel fan. Well, Marvel gotta get it together. But for that being said, Mansion, All I Have, and Wait are my favorite songs on the album. Least favorite songs are Motivated and Turn the Music Up. And so I'm gonna give this debut album of NF an 8.5 out of 10. And I'm really excited to hear his next album, Therapy Session. So stay tuned for that in my next couple of videos. You'll be seeing that drop as well. Like I said, you guys, every Thursday I'll be dropping an album reaction. So don't be afraid to comment below some of the albums that you want me to react to. It could be an NF album or it could be any artist album. I already have a list of some that I have to check out, but if there's enough push for me to check out one of those instead, I'll definitely bump it up the list. But if I have extra free time throughout the week, I'll definitely pump out more than one a week, because I love this and I love the community that we're building, and I'm excited. Almost at 1,000 subs, you know, subscribe, turn the bell on so you know if I'm dropping a video. And hey, share it to other NF fans, share it to other people that really rock with not only hip hop, rock, alternative, R&B. We checking it all. We doing it all over here. So appreciate y'all, care about y'all. See you guys in the next video. It's your boy Jakar. I'll talk to you.